The Supreme Court today upheld the center's move to scrap special status to Jammu and Kashmir under Article 370 of the Constitution. A five-member bench of the Supreme Court led by Chief Justice D.Y. Chandrachud ruled that Article 370 was a temporary provision to ease Jammu and Kashmir's merger with India. The Supreme Court has said that Jammu and Kashmir did not retain sovereignty when it joined India and its Constituent Assembly ceased to exist the moment it merged with India. So what are the big takeaways? Abrogation of Article 370 has been upheld today. There has been a call for elections. In fact, the Supreme Court has told the Election Commission of India that the elections must be held in Jammu and Kashmir by September 2024. Restoration of Jammu and Kashmir statehood will be also done at the earliest. And the Supreme Court has upheld carving out of Ladakh as the separate union territory. The CJI also added that every decision of the center cannot be challenged and that Article 370 was an interim arrangement due to war conditions in the state. Let's discuss last 4 years in Jammu and Kashmir, because it's a landmark verdict, and what does the world of Jammu and Kashmir certainly is post-abrogation. We have Farhana Bhatt, who is an actor, joining me from Mumbai. We have Amal Magazine, financial expert, joining me from Faridabad. Javed Beg is a social activist, joining me from Badgam. Rasik Ahmed Sheikh is who also goes with a stage name, Mekra. His rap, in fact, of Badalta Kashmir went viral, is joining us also from Srinagar. We have Rubal Nagi, who's an artist from Mumbai. Let me begin with you, Rubal. You know, let's discuss the last 4 years. You have worked extensively in Kashmir and you run centers there. What has changed according to you? Give me some anecdotes, share your experiences.
Well, I would say that why talk about only last 4 years? Let's talk about years even beyond that. I mean, we were working, Rubal Nagi Art Foundation started working in Kashmir from 2017. And from 2017 to 2023, I myself have seen such an amazing transformation. Being a Jammu Kashmir daughter, you know, there were times that we would say, it should we go out for dinner? And then my father, being in the army who served, said, you know what, let's do it another day. So, and now, when I go to Kashmir, I go every month. We are running 7 skill centers there. We have more than 400 women who are Kashmiri women and youth who is working with us in the foundation. I see the difference in their approach. I see the difference in their mindset. I see the difference in the overall personality of Kashmiri youths and women of Kashmir. Mera hamesha se ye manna hai ki aap ek beti ko agar badalte hain, ek mahila ko agar badalte hain, to keval uske ghar ko nahi, pure gaon ko badalte hain. And you asked me about giving you an example. Let me give you an example of my central head. Her name is Nigat. And when we started working and shortlisting ki hamare saath kaun kaam karega, she is the one who came up to me and said, ma'am, aap mujhe kaam dijiye, aap mujhe kamane ka sadhan dijiye, main pure gaon ki ladkiyon ko leke aaungi. And I'm so proud of her and my whole team today, that with her hard work and hard work of all the other girls, today we are 400 plus women who are working in Kashmir together. And they're making fantastic products, which is, you know, been worn by everybody in the world. So this is how the change has happened. Pehle bahut push karke mahilaon ko, yuvaon ko ye bolna padta tha, education puri kariye, apne kaam pe dhyan dijiye. But now when girls come to you, they approach you and say, we want to do this. I think that is the change we all wanted to see. And I have seen that every step from when we started in 2017. And then the abrogation of Article 370 in last 4 years, the changes. What I would like to say is, पिछले चार साल में अगर हम थोड़े स्लो स्पीड से चल रहे थे, पिछले चार साल से स्पीड हमारे काम करने की, लोगों के आप तक पहुंचने की और आपके साथ काम करने के लिए जुड़ने की जो है वो बढ़ गई है. सो आई थिंक इट्स अ ब्रिलियंट स्टेप एंड आई एम वेरी हैप्पी दैट ऑनरेबल सुप्रीम कोर्ट हैज गिवन द वर्डिक्ट टुडे एंड मेरी पूरी टीम बहुत खुश है. आई सेड इट इन माय अर्लियर इंटरव्यू कि मुझे दोपहर से बहुत सारे कॉल्स आ रहे हैं. एवरीवन इज वेरी एक्साइटेड एंड एज अ डॉटर ऑफ द सॉयल आई एम टोटली रिलेटेड टू.
Farhana, what about you? I mean, there are moments that you would have enjoyed in Kashmir in recent few months, I would say recent years, from what it was in the past to post 2019. What changed?
So, you know, if you talk about change, then there has been a drastic change. If I talk about girls, as ma'am already spoke before, you know, there has been a change of action, change of mindset, and change of how people approach to any profession or to anything they just get in their way. Mostly girls. I see most, like 4 years ago, there were a lot of, you know, hindrance in their ways. Even in my way, I have been in industry, I have been working since 6 years. But these 4 years, I feel like there has been a really a visible change. Since these 4 years, even all the girls who have been in any profession, or all the boys, there have been the, you know, I won't say there has been a drastic change, but slow and steadily we are approaching towards something which is very good for our development, for mostly for our youngsters. And I think that journey has begun before these 4 years. Before these 4 years, if I speak, there was like we had the ways, we had the schemes, the government was there for us, especially for girls, everything was there, but we didn't have the way, we didn't know how to approach, we were, you know, diverted towards some other ways. If I speak about the youngsters, okay. Boys as well as girls, we had the talent, but we didn't know how we should utilize
that's
it, we couldn't channelize our energy.
The talent is perhaps being channelized in the right way. Amal, you are a financial expert. Working in Faridabad, are you in touch with people in the valley, your family there, and when did you last visit?
Unfortunately, the family has, they don't have anybody left there in Srinagar. We all had to move in 1990 to Delhi and other parts of India. Today is a big day. First of all, I would like to thank the Honorable Supreme Court and the dispensation, you know, there for taking this step. And for the to the Supreme Court that they you know upheld this decision of everybody 370. This was meant to be temporary, as the rightly stated by the Honorable Chief Justice of India. The Article 370 was meant to be temporary, but the polity in Srinagar, the politicians in Srinagar, specifically in Srinagar, they kept it alive. They thrived on it. Their shops were running on it. They always gave this impression that this is something which is a privilege, and 370 was the only reason that, you know, J&K as a state was with India, which was wrong, which was misrepresented, and people there were, you know, meant to believe this, you know, that, you know, this is something very special, you know, what they have, and probably this was one big cause of our exodus also, or the condition, you know, in which the Kashmir is today. As far as me being going there, I have been there, I think, 7-8 times in all these 30-35 years since the exodus has happened. Last was, I think, last month I was there for one day. That's it, you know. I'm not in touch with a lot of people there, but I feel the difference. You know, I feel the difference when I went there for one day, and I feel the difference when I speak to people, you know, on phone or otherwise I interact with them.
You feel the difference. What about Javed Beg, who's a social activist joining me from Badgam? Javed?
Thank you so much for bringing me in this beautiful and august show. I am so happy today. This should have been done 77 years ago. My generation suffered because this so-called article helped some families, some clans, to establish their political empires on the suffering of common Kashmiris like me, like hundreds and thousands of Javeds, like hundreds and thousands of Adityas, like hundreds and thousands of Kashmiris who suffered due to their political ambitions. And today, it's a moment of pride for 1.4 billion Indians that they have done away with something which was only in the mindset of some people. It was a tool of conditioning, which almost of us, you know, all of us have gone through in last 77 years, especially in last 35 years of terrorism.
Okay.
We have been through a conditioning. We were made to believe that this article is holy. It is irreversible. I was made to believe since my childhood, since my school days. But today, I must say, I'm very happy. Okay. Every Kashmiri who believes in humanity, who believes in the idea of India is happy. Yes.
Okay. Before we go to our next guest, who is a Kashmiri rapper, I would like to play one of his work and then I will begin the conversation. Or, since your rap video has gone viral, tell us about the transformation that you say has happened in Kashmir in the last 4 years.
देखिए मैम, अगर बात की जाए, जो भी डेवलपमेंट्स मैंने देखी है 4 साल के अंदर अंदर, वो सारी मैंने पैन डाउन करके अपने रैप के थ्रू एक्सप्रेस कर दी. लाइक उसमें स्मार्ट सिटी प्रोजेक्ट्स जो है मोस्ट हाईलाइटेड चीज मैंने जो है इसमें नोट्स की थी, और G20 का सक्सेसफुल होना ऐसी सिचुएशंस में अगर आप इससे पहले देखा जाए तो इम्पॉसिबल के बराबर था ऐसी मीटिंग्स कश्मीर में होस्ट करना. लेकिन अभी इतना सक्सेसफुली हो पाया, या मैं बिकॉज आई बिलोंग टू साउथ कश्मीर, तो साउथ कश्मीर से बिलोंग करने के बाद भी मैं अगर इन चीजों का एक्सप्रेस ओपनली कर पा रहा हूँ तो डेफिनेटली देयर इज अ ह्यूज डिफरेंस.
Into some specifics here, Rasik, what has changed in the sense that जब आप बोल रहे हैं कि बहुत सारा चीज बदला है, तो क्या बदला है?
सबसे पहले तो आप, अगर मैं आपको एक सिंपल से एग्जांपल दूं, अगर आप 4 साल पहले की न्यूज़ चेक करोगे J&K से, तो मोस्ट प्रोबेबली आपको हर जगह पे, बिकॉज आप तो डेफिनेटली मीडिया के ही साथ हो कनेक्टेड, तो आप आपको ये पता होगा कि अगर आप 4 साल पहले न्यूज यहाँ से जो भी आप लेते थे, तो उनमें आप मोस्टली क्या करते थे, आज इतने लड़कों को PSA दिया गया, आज इतने लड़के अरेस्ट किए गए. लेकिन अभी के टाइम में अगर NDTV न्यूज कवर कर रहा है J&K से, या तो कोई एथलीट होगा या तो मेरे जैसा कोई आर्टिस्ट होगा जिनकी आप स्टोरीज कवर कर रहे हैं, तो देयर इज अ ह्यूज डिफरेंस मैम.
यू नो फरहाना, दैट्स एन इंटरेस्टिंग पॉइंट दैट हैज बीन मेड बाय रूबल, that we are talking about talent from Kashmir, we are talking about success stories from Kashmir, and would you say that that's a huge shift, Farhana?
If you ask me, that is a part of the success and development I have been speaking about, because Kashmir mein kafi sare artists hain, reh chuke hain isse pehle bhi, but they could not come as a Kashmiri artist. They had to, by for one or other reason, they had to shift to Bombay, to Delhi, because yahan pe rehna, literally, even I can tell you that was not really safe being an artist and being someone who is working in Bollywood or working in the music industry or anywhere. So, abhi ke time pe, agar main apne ghar pe baithi hu, I'm sitting at my home, I'm safe and I'm doing work in Kashmir. There are Bollywood projects coming on in Kashmir and I'm working in there. And people know that she is someone who is working, or even a rapper, a singer, anyone from Kashmir. They have their own identity. People know them here. And this is the drastic change. Ki logo mein acceptance aayi hai kahin had tak. And I think, as I told you, this is the journey. We can't just judge ki bas it 4 saal mein kya hua, kya nahi hua. 4 saal mein jo cheeze start ho gayi hain, I'm sure they're going to take our future to a great extent.
Okay. Ms. Nagi, what about you? You know, the history has been very troubled. There are fault lines which were there visible. Would you say that that is the things of the past, or is there a long way to go?
Sorry, I couldn't get you.
See, if I say that everything is gone and, there's nothing that remains anymore, that wouldn't be true. Well, Rome wasn't built in a day. हमारी सबकी कोशिश है, आप सरकार की कहें, कश्मीर के अवाम की कहें, हम सोशल वर्कर्स की कहें, एजुकेशनिस्ट की कहें, जो भी जिन्होंने भी कश्मीर के लिए दिन रात काम किया है, हमारी यही कोशिश है दैट जो थोड़ा 0.5% लोग भी जो मन में कुछ नेगेटिविटी लेके बैठे हैं, वो भी आने वाले समय में हट जाए. एंड वी सी जम्मू एंड कश्मीर as a part, one of the strongest part states of India. मैंने हमेशा कहा है जम्मू कश्मीर केवल एक स्टेट या हमारे देश का हिस्सा नहीं है, हमारे देश के सर का ताज है. So I think to see that change, that positive change in my home state, makes me emotional, because I have seen those times where फॉरगेट अबाउट गोइंग टू लाल चौक, इवन जस्ट डिस्कसिंग दैट हम लाल चौक जरा देख के आए, घंटा घर देख के आए, शुड बी गो आउट फॉर डिनर इन श्रीनगर, एंड वी वर नेवर अलाउड. एंड टूडे एट 11:30, 12 o'clock एट नाइट, इफ यू कैन बी आउट ऑन द स्ट्रीट्स विदाउट फियर, आई थिंक इट सेल्फ इज अ ह्यूज अचीवमेंट फॉर आवर स्टेट. एंड आई थिंक धीरे धीरे ये जो पॉजिटिव चेंज अब शुरू हो चुका है और वी हैव सीन थिंग्स चेंजिंग एंड डेवलपिंग, आई थिंक स्लोली एंड ग्रेजुअली ऑल दोज पीपल विल ऑल्सो ज्वाइन द ग्रुप where you know everyone is talking about that let's create jobs, let's focus on education, let's talk about health facilities, let's talk about getting our state known in a positive way throughout the world. So I think that would happen too, but yes, it will take some time, maybe some more time, but for sure let's keep a positive mind see it happening soon.
Yes, and Rasik also has a very very positive attitude. Rasik, badalta Kashmir, आपने ये गाना कब लिखा और इस पर लिखना जरूरी क्यों समझा?
देखिए मैम, अगर बदलता कश्मीर की मैं बात करूं और मैंने क्यों लिखा, तो मैं आपको बताऊंगा, जो भी हिप हॉप आर्टिस्ट होता है, जो भी हो, ठीक है मैम, तो एक हिप हॉप आर्टिस्ट जो भी लिखता है वो अपनी सराउंडिंग्स को देख के लिखता है, ठीक है मैम. तो मैंने अपनी सराउंडिंग्स में जो भी देखा था, क्योंकि मेरा मूवमेंट होता रहता है श्रीनगर टू साउथ कश्मीर, साउथ कश्मीर टू श्रीनगर, क्योंकि मैं यहाँ पे एक फर्म के साथ कनेक्टेड हूँ, तो वहां पे मैं काम करता हूँ. तो मैंने जो भी डिफरेंसेस रास्ते में आते जाते देखी, उन चीजों को नोट्स करके मैंने ये गाना लिखा था. और गाना लिखने में मेरे को ज्यादा टाइम नहीं, आई गेस इस गाने के लिरिक्स मैंने 3 बार लिखे और 2 बार में खुद से सेटिस्फाई नहीं हो पाया, 3री बार में मैंने कम्प्लीट किया और ज्यादा टाइम नहीं, मैंने आधे घंटे के अंदर अंदर ये गाना लिखा.
हमारे दर्शकों के लिए कुछ सुनाइए.
तो इसका जो गाने का सेकंड वर्स है, मेरे पार्ट में से सेकंड वर्स है, वो मेरा सबसे फेवरेट है, जिसमें मैंने बोला है, अब यहाँ नहीं डर अवाम जिगर में देश का नाम, अब यहाँ बेटा बेटी दोनों करे एक ही काम, अब यहाँ हर एक शहरी की बस्ती देश में जान, हिंदू मुस्लिम सिख ईसाई एक हिंदुस्तान, देश में बस्ती है शान, देश है मेरी शान, हमें कश्मीर हिंदुस्तानी हमें इस बात पे मान, तिरंगा मेरी छाती पे है ये मेरी पहचान, मैं कश्मीरी और देश मेरा हिंदुस्तान.
Okay, would you want few music festivals or perhaps auditions to take place in Kashmir?
Definitely, ma'am. देखिए, अगर मैंने ऐसा गाना अभी introduce किया है तो इससे खाली मुझे फायदा, मैं ये नहीं बताऊंगा कि that मैंने गाना डाल दिया, मैंने एक दिन में 1.5 million cover कर लिए, नहीं ma'am. अगर मैं कश्मीरी आर्टिस्ट हूँ, मेरे साथ और कश्मीरी आर्टिस्ट कनेक्टेड है, मेरा गाना अगर बाहर निकला है तो वो ऑटोमेटिकली बाहर आए, मेरे जो भी फ्रेंड्स हैं उनके साथ और लोग कनेक्टेड है, तो जो भी फायदा मेरे इस गाने से हुआ है वो पूरे सीन को है. और डेफिनेटली मैं चाहूंगा यहाँ पे लाइक MTV हसल जैसे शोज हो रहे हैं तो उनके ऑडिशन बाहर ही होते हैं, मैं चाहूंगा कि कश्मीर में भी ऐसे ऑडिशन हो, नॉट जस्ट MTV हसल या रैप शोज, सिंगिंग शोज जो भी है, तो यहाँ के लोगों को अपॉर्चुनिटीज दी जाए. तो मैं रिक्वेस्ट करूंगा गवर्नमेंट से, अगर ऐसा पॉसिबल हो सकता है तो डेफिनेटली आप यहाँ के लोगों को ऐसी अपॉर्चुनिटीज प्रोवाइड करें.
रासिक, थैंक यू फॉर शेयरिंग योर स्टोरी. रूबल नागी, जावेद अमाल एंड फरहाना, थैंक यू सो मच. सो हियर्स व्हाट द यंग कश्मीरीज हैव टू से ऑन दिस लैंडमार्क वर्डिक्ट, व्हाट हैज चेंज्ड इन द लास्ट 4 years एंड व्हाट दे होप विल चेंज going ahead. That's all from me. I'll be seeing you tomorrow with another episode of The Last Word. Thanks so much.